Hey guys, so for today's video, we're gonna be talking about my February favorites. I don't typically do like a monthly favorites video, but I have a couple products from this month that I've really been liking and I just wanted to share with you guys, make this kind of fun and quick. I got maybe like 6 products or so, but let's do it. I am wearing a lot of these products on my face right now, so I'm gonna play some clips of me applying the products as I'm talking about them so you can kind of see them in action. I think I'm gonna go kind of in like order of application because that just makes more sense to me. All right, so the first product I've been loving this month, this is probably my favorite product of this month, and it's actually a skincare product. This is the Inkylist Salicylic Acid Cleanser. Where do I even begin with this? We all know I struggle with acne. I don't have like terrible acne, but what my problem is I get like clogged pores that they're not actual like whiteheads or blackheads, they're just clogged pores that I like to pick at pretty much. And I think I posted a video, it was either earlier this month or in January, where my face was a mess, but I was also because of like my diet and just like water intake in general. So around that time I purchased this cleanser on Sephora because I kind of realized in my skincare routine, I didn't really have any products that really targeted acne. I would use like spot treatment, but I didn't use any like cleanser or a serum or anything. So I just want to start with like a simple cleanser that would help with acne. And this had great reviews on Sephora and it's so inexpensive. I think it was like, I want to say $12 or so, like super duper cheap. And my skin has been loving this cleanser. When I use it every day, I kind of notice like my pores look better, my overall texture is a lot better. And what I really like about this too is that it doesn't dry out my skin. It has a really creamy, smooth texture when you apply it. And then like after you're done rinsing your face, like my skin's not super tight or anything. So I love that. And I'm just very impressed with this cleanser and I'm going to keep using it. Okay, another skincare product I've been loving is the Isle of Paradise Face High Glow Self Tan Serum. So if you didn't know, I love to self tan. And over the past couple months, I kind of stopped self tanning, but I got back into tanning when the gyms opened. Kind of random. Anyway, so I've been self tanning pretty much weekly now, like I'm always have a tan on. And if you've ever self-tanned, you kind of know that it doesn't last on your face very long. Just because we wash our faces a lot, you know, we're applying makeup and just we're always messing with our faces, so the tan never really lasts. And before this product, I was actually using their tanning drops that are kind of meant more for your body, and I was using those on my face, but those drops would make me kind of orange and it would make my hands so orange as well. So when they launched this, I think it was earlier this year, I picked it up right away and I really, really like it. So you just apply 4 to 12 drops directly to your face. I like it because you don't have to mix it with the moisturizer like you would with the other drops. Like this one is meant for your face. And I probably use this about like every other day when I have a tan on and it just keeps my face nice and tan. I have also used this when I didn't have a tan on my body, but like when I'm pale, I am just so pale and I just don't really like how my face looks when it's super pale. So I did use this just on my face and neck and it did give me just a nice little glow if you just use like a couple drops. So I don't know, if you self tan, I think you'd really like this because it's meant for your face, where a lot of self tanners aren't meant for your face. So a foundation I've been loving this month, this is so, so random because no one talks about this, but I'm obsessed with it. It's the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Foundation Full Coverage Moisturizer. I believe I got this last year. I did like a sponsorship with Ulta and I picked up this foundation and I was like, okay, cool. And then I've been using it a lot more this month and I was like, I freaking love this. But I love the coverage, I love the texture. It is so moisturizing and it's called a full coverage moisturizer and it just looks so beautiful on my skin. It does also have SPF 50 in it, which is just a bonus, but as a foundation itself, I've been loving it. Okay, so a newer product, I just started using this like maybe a week ago, but it's already a favorite and I knew like the second I put it on, I am obsessed. And that is the Anastasia Brow Freeze. So my eyebrows are microbladed and I have a lot of brow hairs in general, like my brows are pretty full. So I got a lot to work with. For me, my brows grow kind of crazy. So like the tails just start doing whatever they want. They kind of grow downwards. And so sometimes I get the service called a brow lamination done, which is pretty much like a perm for your eyebrows that just make your brows kind of stand straight up. And I love that service, I love getting it done, I love the way it looks, but this product like gives me the brow lamination look that I've been wanting and needing. And I think the name Brow Freeze is perfect because it literally does freeze your brows in place. And I feel like it really does give that brow laminated look where your brows are just like plastered to your face, but in such a good way. Like, I've tried so many clear brow gels and none of them would hold my brows up all day. I've also tried like the Patrick Ta, this is the shaping wax, and like this worked okay, but it was like really finicky to use. It's so easy to use. You don't have to like get your spoolie wet or anything. It's, you know, it's not like the soap method. You just take your spoolie, dip it in here just a little bit and go to town on your brows. It's almost kind of like a little jelly texture in there. Like, it's really easy to pick up the product and I'm obsessed with it. So how I use this is I fill in my brows first. I'll use like a brow pen, do some brow strokes, take my brow pencil, you know, fix my tails, and then go straighten with this product and my brows will last all day beautifully. And then a new product I've been loving are the Salt New York cream blush and bronzers. So I think we all know that like cream blush and bronzers are like all the rage right now. I love cream blushes, but I couldn't really find a cream bronzer that I liked a lot. You know, I've tried the Fenty cream bronzers and I thought they were pretty good, but I was like, it's not perfect. I need something better. And Samantha Ravenel has talked about this brand and their products, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna try them. So I went on their website, and they have like a little bundle deal, which I really liked. They have like two palettes. I got the small palette, and it's really nice, like super cute packaging with the zipper, and it's magnetic. It has a magnetic closure, which I love, especially since there's creams in here. So then I bought two bronzers and two blushes. What shades did I get? Okay, so this is the bronzer in light. This is the bronzer in light medium, and then I got the blush in rose and spice. There's also a little mirror in this palette, but it's not a very good quality mirror, but the palette overall I do like. So pretty much you can kind of pick what shades you want on their website, and they did have cream highlighters as well, like same packaging and everything, but I have enough highlighters. I really wanted to try their cream bronzers. That's what I really wanted on their website. So I've been using these cream bronzers and I think they're so pretty. I think I do like the formula better than the Fenty ones. The undertones are really nice. They're super creamy. They blend so easily, whether you're using like a brush or a sponge. I think I could possibly get one more shade deeper in the bronzer when I have a fake tan on, but the shades are so, so pretty. And I think I would call this an indie brand. I was watching the owners, the girl who created the products, I was watching her videos on YouTube, and she's like so funny, so cool. So I'm happy to support kind of a smaller company like this. So I'd recommend you check them out if you're looking for cream blush, bronzers, or highlighters. Speaking of Samantha Ravenel, another one of my favorites this month is the Auric Smoke Reflex little eyeshadow duos. I bought these myself when they launched, and I've just been loving using these on days where I just want to do a simple eye look. I don't really want to like think about creating a look. I just want to throw something on my eyes and call it good, which is kind of exactly what I did today. I used the shade Temper, I used the cream all over my lids, and a little bit of the shimmery powder on top, added some mascara, a little bit of eyeliner, good to go. I just think the shades are so beautiful and perfect for every day, especially if you have either Temper or Defiance. Ego is the more kind of like gray smoky one, but for an everyday look, these two are my favorite. And I just think they're so easy to use. Like, at first it was kind of a learning process, learning how to use the creams, but I found that I just use my finger to apply it all over my lid, blend it out with the brush, and that's it. So I'm loving these products and I'm excited to see what else Auric comes out with. All right, I got two more products I wanna talk about. One being a mascara that I've been loving, and this is the new Makeup Geek Extension Effect Mascara. I feel like with mascaras, you kind of know right away whether you're gonna love it or hate it. And the second I put this one on when I first tried it, I was obsessed. I love the way it makes my lashes look. I'm wearing this today, obviously. I love the wand of it. I've said this so many times. I love just a good, simple wand. I don't need some like curvature wand with a spiky ball on top. Like, just give me a good basic wand and I'm happy. The formula is beautiful. I find that it doesn't really flake or smudge on me, so that's always a plus. And that's just kind of been like my go-to mascara for this month. And then my last favorite for this month is kind of random, but it's a perfume, and that is YSL Black Opium. This is not a new perfume whatsoever. Honestly, I've been wearing this perfume for years, but I've really wanted to have like a signature scent, you know? I probably own maybe like 6 or 7 perfumes and I just kind of rotate between them, but I wanted to have one that I just wear all the time. And that's this one. I just think it's just so sexy. What are the notes? Let's read it. Honestly, I'm sure that so many of you have smelled this before because again, it's nothing new. The fragrance family is warm and spicy. The key notes are black coffee, white flowers, and vanilla. Mmm, so good. I would just call this a sexy perfume, and I've been wearing it so much in the month of February, so I just had to include it in this video. All right, and I think that's gonna wrap up my February favorites. I told you this was gonna be a short and sweet favorites video, but I hope you guys liked it. Let me know if you have any favorite products from February. I would love to know and check them out. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.